Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Mohave Valley United Methodist Church. Well, hi. And a special welcome to Needles. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for inviting
me. We're glad that you're here. We're very glad you're here. Yes, we're going to have a little children's time with Reverend Morley here. I'd like to also introduce our guest pastor, Reverend Dan Morley.
It's good to be with you today. Good morning. Good morning. Good to see you all today. So we gather up here right now at the beginning of worship, right? And you get ready to then go to Sunday school class? So this is our welcome time to gather, and a time to focus upon our worship time. My name is Dan Morley. I'm a pastor, and I'm the district superintendent for our area, and so it is awesome to be here with you, each and every one of you. This is a beautiful church, and I can see why others have told me so before I even came here. When I see each one of you, you are wonderful. We're going to get ready for worship right now, so I want to ask you the question. How do you call somebody? How would you do that? If you were going to call, what would you do? Yes, Trevor?
On a phone.
On a phone. A telephone? Is that the best way to call somebody? I think so, isn't it?
No, like your cell phone.
Like your cell phone? Or the landline at home? A phone. That's how you call somebody, right? Is that the first thing you think of? Well, now, we say that Jesus called the disciples. But how could he do that when there was no phone? What do you think? Okay, I'm going to let somebody else. Yes. What do you think? No phone, how do you call somebody? No. Okay, another thought? Yeah. You could write a note. Oh, that would be a good way. Yeah. Another thought? Did you have another thought? You keep thinking. Yeah. With your voice, you could just call out to them and say, hey. Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Alrighty. Yep. There you go. What do you say, Trevor? What's another one? Or was that what you were thinking of? Okay. Good. So you think lots of ways that you can call somebody, not just the telephone, but lots of ways. You can call out to them. You can write them a note. Or Jesus, he simply went up to people and said, "Hey, my name is Dan. I'd like to meet you. Hello." And he would meet them just like that. And that's how he would call out to them too. He would meet them one by one and say, it is so good to be in worship with you and in this time with you. And then he would say to them, would you be my friend? Yeah. And they would say, yeah. Yeah. That's how Jesus would call people. He would meet them one by one and let each one know that it is so good to be with you today. Hey. And so we do that to each other, with each other too. We call out to each other, welcome each other, in the name of Jesus. So you all have a great time in your Sunday school today, learning about Jesus and learning about the faith. All right? Great. Thank you for being up here with me today. You all just go now, or? Okay, go to Sunday school. Have a good time.
Outstanding. Outstanding. Aren't they beautiful? Aren't they beautiful? All right, well, we've got some announcements. First one I'd like to announce, there's no men's breakfast on September 12th. We had it yesterday. And so that's been canceled. We're going to have a truck on Tuesday to the food bank. So anybody that would like to come in and give a hand, you know, you're welcome. We appreciate the help. And also, Smith's is having a case lot sale. So if you just, you know, maybe wanted to pick up a case or something, whatever you can, bring it down to the food bank, it'd be wonderful. It's a great sale. I think it's going on until Tuesday. So we have the admin meeting on September 28th at 6 p.m. And let's see, what else do we have here? The garage sale's coming up. Semi-annual garage sale is going to be October 16th. And we'll start setting up on the 15th. So if you'd like to come and help for that, that'd be fantastic. And let's see here. Also, because your donations, the food pantry was able to supply food for 260 people during the week of August 24th. And that translates into 5,200 meals for a two-week period. So it's wonderful that we can serve and have this to help others. And we also, like I said, we wanted to welcome Reverend Morley here this morning. He's our district superintendent. And I think that's about it. Yes?
I know it's in the bulletin, but I just want to refresh everybody's memory.
There's a Spirit Circle agenda meeting on Wednesday morning at 9 o'clock. And even though the president is not here, we are still having the meeting, and it hopefully we'll get everything planned out for the 14th.
Outstanding. Anyone else?
Yeah, I just wanted to advise everybody that in the celebration of Labor Day, we're not having a Bible study tonight. This is to honor all the working people out there who are supporting our Social Security checks.
Thank you.
I just wanted to, even though, like Judy said, it's in the bulletin, but I want to remind the handbell people that we will be having handbell practice on Wednesday at 6 o'clock. And if you would like to join the handbells, you're perfectly welcome to be there. We love having a new person.
Thank you. Also, I just remembered the ladies' Bible study.
Tuesday, 5:30.
Tuesday, 5:30. That's still going on. So, do we have any other announcements?
Just that we have choir practice.
Oh, choir practice?
Wednesday night.
7 o'clock.
Good morning. I want to mention that the search program training is going to be starting next week. The community emergency response team, the meetings are going to be non-duplicated. The first week on Friday, September 11th at 6 p.m. to 9, and on Saturday, 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., that'll be at the Bullard City Fire Department building number 2 on Highway 95 North. And then the following week, the meetings are held at Mohave Valley Fire Department. And those meetings also Friday 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. and Saturday 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. These classes are not duplicated, and from what I understand, there's a lot of new programs we're trying to get into progress, but we need a lot of new blood. We'd like to get some young people down there to help out. Thank you.
All right, thank you.
I just wanted prayers. I'm leaving next Sunday for Ireland, and when I get back from that, I'll be going to Oregon, so I won't be back until middle of October. I need prayers. I'll be on the road in Bend, and I need it in the air, too.
You got it. Are there any other announcements? One more.
One question.
Yes.
Who are you?
My my name is Rick Bird. I usually attend the first service. I run the sound system and the cameras and do the internet stuff. You're welcome.
Ada Cleveland is on the prayer list, and right now she's really needs a prayer. She's in the hospital, and it's not good. Thank you.
Alrighty, if there's no more announcements, then if everyone would stand and join me in the intro, this is the day. This morning is the Apostles' Creed. It'll be in your psalter portion of the hymnal, page 881. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our celebration hymn is In Christ There Is No East or West, page number 548. Concerns? Do we have
any? I would like to place Jan Ward back on our prayer list. She got over the heart operation fine, but now she's doing chemo and radiation for a spot they discovered on her lung during the heart surgery. So She needs all kinds of prayers. Thank you.
Linda's brother, Pete Rozelle, has some serious health issues. We'd like to have him on the prayer list, please.
Are there any other joys or concerns?
Yeah, I'll pray for you, the Lord Jesus. My brother Jerry's been on the prayer list for quite a while, and he's cancer free.
I have both a joy and a concern. Joy is my husband had his biopsy yesterday, and everything looked good. We go back on Friday. He got through the procedure easy. We were out of there about 45 minutes after he was done with his procedure. He was eating ice and flirting with the nurses, so I know he's doing okay. My concern, for those of you who know her, Nola Charles is having some major medical issues, so put her on her prayer list, please.
Welcome my kids from Southern California. They're not first time visitors, but it's been a while since they've been here. Jim Haslett and Jerry White.
Well, welcome. Welcome. Glad to have you here.
So I have a joy today. I just want to introduce my grandma. She came to the second service to hear me play the piano, and that's good.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. You're welcome.
I think we need prayers for Pastor and Nancy who are traveling, and the rest of our travelers who are out there too.
Absolutely.
As Reverend Morley suggested, we should be saying hello to Jesus, also hello to our friends. I had the distinct pleasure of visiting via the telephone with Ruth Root, who is a member of our church, I have her telephone number. She'd be delighted to get a call from her. She's living in Phoenix with her family and doing quite well. And says hello, and she loves everyone here.
Outstanding. That's wonderful. Yeah. Right away.
I had a call this week from Beverly Johnson. Her son is on the prayer list and has been for quite some time. And she said that she feels like this is the beginning of the end, that he has 4 lesions on his brain, and he was getting ready to go undergo some treatment, but she said she and he both have appreciated all of your prayers, and if you just keep him in your prayers a little bit longer.
Also, my sister Joyce Collins has been in and out of the hospital, yes, and we have to determine what it is.
Thank you.
All right. Yeah, I just want to thank everybody. They were thinking of us, and we just got back from our 3-month trip. So I'm very happy to be back home for the church. Love you all. Thank you.
Thank you. If there's no other, one more.
I think we've been amiss kind of not introducing our guest pastor's wife. She's here also. And also prayers for Carol, our director. Her husband's been ill and in the hospital.
Thank you. Are there any others? All right, there's no others. Well, this time we'll go into a time of silent prayer and pastoral prayer. And the Lord's Prayer will be at the table. So if you will now just join me in a time of silent prayer. Thank you, Lord, for this beautiful day that you've given us to come together and worship you. Thank you for being among us. Thank you for being within us. And Father, we just thank you for being. Lord, we lift up those who are sick or infirm, who are traveling. And Father, we just ask that your healing hand, your hand of grace and mercy be upon them. We thank you for all your gifts. We thank you for all you give us and all you do for us. We thank you for your salvation through your grace and mercy. And we thank you. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Stand with me for the glory of God.
Bye.
Prisoners by the law, locked up until faith should be revealed. So the law was put in charge to lead us to Christ, that we may be justified by faith. Now that faith has come, we are no longer under the supervision of the law. You are all sons of God through faith in Jesus Christ. For all of you who were baptized into Christ have clothed yourself with Christ. There is neither Jew nor Greek, slave nor free, male nor female, for you are all one in Jesus Christ. If you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. This is the word of the Lord. Let us continue our service this morning as we share our gifts and our offerings. Let our ushers please come forward.
Number 593.
Here I am.
So as we open the Bible, please open your hearts to receive the gift of the word, the calling of the 12. One of those days, Jesus went out to a mountainside to pray and spent the night praying to God. When morning came, he called his disciples to him and chose 12 of them, whom he also designated apostles. Simon, whom he named Peter, his brother Andrew, James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, son of Alphaeus, Simon, who was called the Zealot, Judas, son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. This is God's holy word. Thanks be to God indeed. Would you pray with me, please? We thank you, O Lord, for the gift of your word. And we pray that the meditations of our hearts and the words which are spoken now, O Lord, be found acceptable to you. O Lord, our rock and our Savior. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
It was a beautiful drive in this morning from Vegas. That's where Bonnie and I live, up in Vegas, and serving as the superintendent over in the North District. But it's just the first weeks of that service as I've come out of a local church and serving in a local church in this area for some time and enjoying it. And now a new adventure with each one of you, with this church and with all of our churches in the Valley. And the superintendency, and it's a blessing to do so, and certainly a blessing to be here. Needles, thank you. Delighted that you've made the drive this way as well. It's a blessing to worship with you all. And that you are one congregation in so many ways, in two different places, and yet one. And that's what we heard about in the scripture readings. That's what we've sung about today. How it is our Lord makes us one with each other, one with him. And how it is we celebrate around this holy table, that very gift. So as Bonnie and I were driving in this morning, we just enjoyed the beauty of the morning as the sun came up, because it was kind of early. And you know how it is in the desert, when the first light of the morning hits that desert. It's a beautiful place, isn't it? There's something majestic and awesome in the desert. But one has to be here to find the beauty that's here, and to discover it, and to be open to it, and to see what a wonder God has given us all around us, and how thankful we are for it. I'm sure that's why Jesus gathered with his disciples and all who were following him up on a mountainside as well, is to watch that sunrise. A beautiful sunrise coming up on the hillsides that day. He spent the night in prayer because it was a meaningful, significant, and momentous occasion that was upon him and the people. On the journey that Jesus was on and what he came to bring us from God Almighty, he was to call the 12, so he spent a night in prayer, and then the sun came up. And it was a new day. A new day in the life for Jesus and for all who were with him. So many would come to listen to Jesus share and speak and tell the stories and the parables and then to heal, and they gathered around him, so many of them. We don't know how many were there that day on that hillside. But when we look at other places where it speaks of like the 5,000 and the bread and the fish that were spread among them, it would have been a large number of people who were gathered there. And then Jesus called out from the midst the 12, called for them into a special place of service. How God calls us into service and connects and touches each one of us. It was Pastor Gene who let me know some time ago when I first was appointed into the office, and he said, "Dad, I need you to come to Mohave Valley, and I want to find that time for you to come and lead in worship and to be a part of it, because I want you to see the gift that I have been given in this church, and to see beautiful, loving people that I have been able to connect with here, and why this is the best church ever." In Mohave Valley, indeed. I come to see how that is so. When I look out to you here this morning, been able to meet you, connect with each, several around the church, and in time, even more, I know. I see what Gene is speaking of, and why it is this is a dear place to him. I can only imagine how it was for Jesus up on the hillside, of course. Wouldn't you have loved to have been there? Just to be there to receive, and for Jesus to look out across, around his congregation and see in their eyes beloved, loving people. Because that's what Jesus would draw out of people love. He would draw to people the grace of God. He would connect with them and look into their lives and even see the Almighty Spirit within. That's how it ought to be why so many people would gather with him. Because all of us are blessed by that. When we experience being in the presence of God, and we experience then that even we are gifted with God, His Spirit just touching us and within ourselves, and how Jesus would just draw that out of people. He would look into their lives and be able to see that and be able to connect with them one by one. Just like with the children, calling them one by one and meeting one by one. How Jesus does that with us when we gather around this holy table today. He just calls that out from us. It's a gift that Jesus gives to us. His holy presence. In a way that he... How was it that he was able to do that? Was he was able to just go up to those who exactly needed to be called forth into a particular purpose and a ministry. That day he called forth 12 of them out of that large group. You know what it was in that day for a rabbi to call disciples around him? He would look out and he would choose from among those who were following him. The rabbis would choose the best and the brightest and the most capable and the most highly educated and those who had the gifts that it would take to follow the rabbi. Because when one would follow the rabbi, what one would seek to do is to be like the rabbi, to do what the rabbi would do, to teach like the rabbi would teach, to have the actions and the ways of reaching out as the way the rabbi would do. And so all those who would become disciples of the rabbi would seek to do just that. So the rabbi would choose only those people who could follow his way. Jesus had gathered around him lots of people. Who did he choose? Did he choose the brightest? Did he choose the most highly educated? Did he choose the movers and the shakers in the community? It didn't seem so. He chose out from that group of people, those whom others would have passed on by, because he could look into them and see, I'm looking for particular people. I'm looking for those who can learn how to do what I'm doing. And what did Jesus do but to love people, to forgive, and to grace, and to connect people one to another? He looked for those who were able to do that and who had that gift about it. But if you would ask others then, how would you choose to start up a new church? How do you choose to start, have a new church start like Jesus was doing and have a new initiative that he had? What would you do if you called a consultant in, like churches will do, calling consultants in to try to find out what should be the strategic steps that we take and how do you build this group of people around you to do just what you're called to do? Well, who would they pinpoint? Maybe it would be something like this. Like a letter that I came across. A letter that is as though it would have been written to Jesus back then by a consultant company. Dear sir, they wrote to him. Thank you for submitting the resumes of the 12 men you have picked for managerial positions in your new organization. It is the staff opinion that most of your nominees are lacking in background. Most of your nominees are lacking in any kind of education and vocational aptitude for the type of enterprise that you're undertaking. Simon Peter, he is emotionally unstable and given to fits of temper. Andrew has absolutely no qualities of leadership, and the two brothers, James and John, the sons of Zebedee, they place personal interest above company loyalty. And Thomas, he demonstrates a questioning attitude that would tend to undermine morale. We feel that it is our duty to tell you that Matthew has been blacklisted by the Greater Jerusalem Better Business Bureau. And James, the son of Alphaeus and Thaddeus, definitely have radical leanings, and they both registered a high score on the manic depressive scale. However, there is one particular candidate who stands head and shoulders above the rest, and he has the greatest of potential. He's a man of ability and resourcefulness. He meets people well. He has a keen business mind and has contacts in high places, and he's highly motivated. He's ambitious. He's responsible. We recommend Judas Iscariot as your controller and your right-hand man. Oh, this world looks to different signs and to different things that say who God is looking for, who Jesus is looking for. Where do you go in this community to rub elbows or to connect with other people? Where do you go? Have you ever done people watching? Do you enjoy doing that? Going places where people are hanging out and just doing some people watching? Where do you go in Mohave Valley to people watch anyway? Where do you go?
Walmart.
Walmart? Ah! Well, you can see, yeah, the world kind of walked by when you were attention. Whoa. I remember when we lived in Kingman, where we would go also, yes, to the Walmart, but also to Centennial Park, where the ball fields were. And they are. You go and you see the whole community there playing ball and having a good time, and the kids in the playground, and that's where you would meet people and connect with other people. Where do we go in the community? To kind of meet others and find out who they are. People watch. So Jesus was up on the hillside doing some people watching. But Jesus would watch people differently than we often watch people. Because when we watch people, too often we're looking them up and down, you know? Trying to judge and to decide, okay, who are they? And evaluate people by what they're wearing and how they look and the other people they mix with. And Jesus didn't quite do it that way, we know. He would meet people and connect with people in a way that would look into their hearts and say, who I see in you is somebody who can do what I do. Now, you know when a rabbi would pick somebody out of the crowd and say that to them? It was an honor. It would lift them up. Anybody chosen to be the disciple of a rabbi who was at the very top tiers of that society, anybody who was picked out of the crowd to say, you could do what I do. Me? Me? You really think I can be that kind of a teacher? Can be one who other people respect and other people love and cherish? Jesus looked into Simon Peter and said, yes, you, brother, you. Because I can see in you somebody who can know the depths of a love for another. It can experience that. Jesus would draw it out of somebody. Somebody who didn't even think it was in themselves. Whenever we meet Jesus, and as we do on a Sunday morning, worshiping here and gathering around the table, may it be for all of us, as we receive this gift of Holy Communion, that we are hearing Jesus calling out to us. Calling out to us to say, I see in you somebody who can grace other people. Somebody who can show other people a new way of living. And who can be one who is a part of this new kingdom that is coming to be all around us. The very kingdom and the grace of God that is just moving around us. So I was with a group of youth this summer up at Potosi Pines Camp, our United Methodist camp up out of Vegas in the Spring Mountains. And there would the youth come, the junior and senior hires, they come from around the district and around the area to camp. You never know who you're going to get. You never know who's going to gather up there on that mountainside. And there they were coming for the very first day, and I'd look around that group who was gathering in the retreat center, and I would wonder, how will I ever be able to connect here? Will they receive me? Will I they? And how will we be able to be a community? The church. You see, wherever we're gathered together and we experience Christ in our midst, there's the church happening. I wondered and I questioned, can we be the church here in this mountaintop? So I began to pray. Because anytime you're in a group trying to lead junior hires, you pray. So I did. I prayed that the Lord would bless all of us who were gathered there, that somehow in a miraculous way we would experience the kingdom in our midst. That's what Jesus did here. Before he called the 12, he prayed all through the night. When we pray and we ask God to reveal to us the very kingdom, God's presence, it happens. And we can see it in our neighbor, and we can know Christ who's right next to us. Yes, I would love to have been on the hillside those many years ago to listen to Jesus speaking, to watch him do the miracles. And Jesus gave us the gift of that this very morning, at this very time, when we gather around this mountaintop, around this table, and we receive the bread and we receive the cup. We're receiving Jesus and he's with us. And then we can turn to our neighbor and we can look into our neighbor and we can see into them the very living Christ who's all around us, through us, and in us. So I came to learn what that word Potosi really means up there on the mountain. You know, isn't that a peculiar name, Potosi? is pronounced in how many different ways, Potosi and Potosi and Potosi Pines. It's a camp that has a name that's derived from a name in Bolivia, the name of a mountain there, of a mine, a silver mine. A silver mine that meant in Potosi's name, fortune, wealth, greatness. Anything that was of the greatest of value would become to be called a Potosi. And so I read about this Potosi here, and the Potosi in Mexico, San Luis Potosi. Out of something small will come something great, is behind the name. Isn't that beautiful? Significant. Out of something small will come something magnificent. Jesus looking into Peter, looking into James and John and Thaddeus and all the others. Out of you will come a greatness, a beauty. Out of you will come the very spirits of the living God among us and with us. That's what Jesus was able to do and is able to do today when you come to receive Holy Communion, to look into you and say, out of you comes this greatness. The very Spirit of God is with us all. In the name of Jesus the Christ, we gather with him around this table, a holy table, and we remember that night in which he gave himself up for us. And we look into the disciples' eyes then as he looks into your eyes today. And the grace of God draws out the very gift and the beauty in one another. And Jesus, knowing that they would have to have the strength of God and all that they would need for the road that would be ahead for them in the days to come, he took the bread of the covenant. He lifted it to God and he said, thanks be to God for the gift of the bread. And then he broke it. And when he broke it, he gave it to his disciples. My body, it is broken for you for the forgiveness of sins. And he took the cup then, and again he lifted it to God. Thanks be to God for the gift. And he gave it to his disciples. My blood, it is shed for you. Forgiveness of sin and for life everlasting. As often as you do this, said Jesus, do this in remembrance of me. And we pray. O Holy Spirit, descend upon all of us gathered here. May your Spirit flow among us and be upon us here and now. May Jesus dine with us as we gather around his table, as he welcomes each and every one. Bless us, O Lord, at this time, that we would come close to you, and you would draw us close to one another. It is in the name of Jesus we pray, just as he has taught us how to pray that precious prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The Lord's table. All are welcome to come to receive. They will be passed among us this day, the bread and the cup, for you to receive, to partake of the greatest gift of all. But those who are assisting, please now come to serve us. Receive the bread and hold it in your hand. And as all have received, we will together partake.
Thank you.
gifts. Send us forth from this place, O Lord, to be that gift to the world. For it is in his name that we pray. Amen. So we sing together the song which indeed does send us forth out into this day, out into the world. Let us sing together. The Lord of the Dance.
Thank you.
this blessing and a benediction, which sends us forth. And so believe in God. God believes in you. Believe in Jesus. Have faith in Jesus. For Jesus has faith in you. For he has called you to be the church, his disciples. So go forth, church, and do just that. For he indeed is the Lord of our lives. Amen.